Hello and welcome to our method tutorial series on creating a basic app. In the last video, we created a delete button, but it shows when a user wants to add a new car, and that doesn't make sense. When adding a new car, this delete button should be hidden. So customize this screen and then select the delete button. Over in its properties, we see load state. When a user navigates to this screen, we can set how the delete button first behaves. Regular is normal visibility, disabled means it's grayed out and ignores any interaction with it, and hidden means it's invisible. Select hidden, and then save this, and close. And the delete button is gone. However, you probably see a problem with this. If I go to my car list and select a car to edit it, oh no. The delete button is invisible here too. How do we turn it back on? If you guessed conditional statement, you're right. If a person is editing a car, show the delete button. Otherwise, we should hide the delete button. Of course, you're probably thinking, wait, Errol, what event does that go in? Good job. We're familiar with events in controls, but did you know the screen also has events? Customize this screen, and then navigate to the screen's properties. Down in the actions, you will find three events. For the most part, the load event happens when the user first views the screen. The focus event happens every time the user views the screen. And the active record change event happens when the screen active record ID changes. That's the one we want. Select it. Now we can make our conditional statement. Find the conditional statement action and add it. Add a new condition. Uh-oh, wait, what's the condition? How do we say user is editing car when we can't use those exact words? Question, how does the screen know the user is editing a car? Here's a hint. The record ID of the car is stored in the screen active record ID of the session. And every record ID is either 1 or greater. See where we're going with this? If the screen active record ID is greater than 0, then the user is editing a record. Let's throw that in as a condition. In the first drop-down, search for screen active record ID and select it. Change the operation to greater than, not greater or equal to. Then in the next drop-down, choose number. And for the number, keep it at the default of 0. There we go, we finished the condition. In the internal notes, type in if screen active record ID is greater than 0. Let's put in more actions. On the left, hover over if then and click on the plus symbol. Search for the action show hide controls and select it. For the control, choose delete and keep it at show. In the internal notes, type show delete button. Now hover over the else and click the plus symbol. Search for the same show hide controls action and select it. Choose the delete control and select hide. Internal note is hide delete button. Okay, let's take a look at our conditional statement. If the screen active record ID is greater than 0, that means the user is editing a car and we show the delete button. Else, the screen active record ID is 0 or less, and that means the user is adding a new car, so we hide the delete button. Does it work? Let's try it out. Close the action editor. On the left, we'll select our cars app and then add a new car. Delete button is invisible. Awesome. Let's go back and now select an existing car. And there it is, our delete button in all its glory. Amazing. One last thing for our app. Wouldn't it be cool if we were to navigate to a contact and we could see the cars in their app ribbon? That'd totally be cool. So we're going to do that in the next video. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Bye-bye.